presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to navigate between slides in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you have a specific way that you like to navigate between slides and anyone else that has a different way, you think that they're just crazy, go ahead and subscribe, give me a thumbs up, all that fun stuff. So, believe it or not, there are several ways to navigate between slides in ProPresenter 7. So, I thought that we would go through just a few of them and see which one would work best for you. So, let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in ProPresenter, of course. Let me scroll down and get to a playlist that has maybe a song in it. Yeah, okay, this will work. So the first thing, you can see my mouse moving. You can always just click on a particular one. Notice I still have my key in, so I'm gonna take that out. So you can click on anyone in specific. Notice that one also changed the look. Let me get rid of that. Okay, and so that's the first way, is just mousing and clicking. Now there is a downside of doing that. If you click and you hold it down and then you inadvertently move, notice it wants to drag. So that's why in general I don't recommend this as a good way to navigate. Personally, the way that I do it is the space bar most of the time. So notice I'm just hitting the space bar and it's going from one to the other. Nice and simple. But what if whoever's up front leading either forgets where they are, or let's say the Holy Spirit moves. Doesn't matter to me. I'm not judging. I'm just saying I don't know where they're going. We talked about one way, or they said, hey, just wing it. No matter what, how do I get between stuff? Well, you see these letters right here. So if I recognize, oh, that's actually the first verse, I can just tap A. If it's verse 2, S, and so on. If you want to know what those are, I have another class just on these, which are called hotkeys. I'll leave a link below the video to that. So that's another way. What if, though, you realize you're on verse 1 after they've left this slide and your mouse is elsewhere and you don't want to go back and forth, anything like that? Well, what you can do is you can type in the number and then enter or return, depending on your keyboard. So do that, and that will take you directly to that. So if I wanted 10, I would type 10 return, and that would take me to that just immediately. So that's a great way to do it as well. The reason why you need the return, by the way, is because there are more than 10 slides. With the hotkeys, we have 26 letters of the alphabet, so we can just type in any one of those 26, and it will hop to the correct slide that has that hotkey on it. But in this case, there are only 10 characters, numeric characters. So if you wanted to go to verse 11 and it was one on, then that just wouldn't work. So instead, 1, enter, takes you to slide 1. 1, 1, enter, takes you to slide 11. So just another way to do that. Finally, and this whole thing was inspired by someone in my church that came from another church where the ProPresenter laptop, she had worn out the key that she uses because she just prefers that, and that is the arrow key. So you can absolutely use the right arrow for next, the left arrow for previous, and let's actually go to a different one here. Yeah, let's go to this. So right arrow for next, left arrow for previous, but if you do the down, should take me to announcements here, and it does. And up takes me back to the presentation that I was on before. So the reason that I personally prefer to use the space bar is because it's nice and big. I'm not accidentally going to hit the down arrow when I meant to hit the right arrow. See, that could take me to a totally different presentation and a different slide, and now I'm lost. So that's personally why I prefer to do it that way. So why don't you leave a comment in the field below and tell me which is your favorite way to go ahead and navigate between slides in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. I'll give you a login and you can take that class for free, just at your leisure. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.